Hi guys, in this video I just like to share with you the kinds of batteries that I use for my test equipment. Primarily I only use rechargeable nickel metal hydride batteries for my test equipment, and the brands that I prefer are Fujitsu and Inalop rechargeable batteries. I use other kinds of batteries before, other brands of rechargeable batteries before, but I did not have good experience with them. So I just stick to this Japanese brand rechargeable batteries, Inalop and Fujitsu. The reason why I prefer rechargeable batteries is that they are not prone to leak. Now, I am not saying that rechargeable batteries will not ever leak. I'm only saying that in my experience, not one of my rechargeable batteries has ever leaked. So for instance, in my Hyoki IR4057, this one is loaded with 4 AA Inalop batteries. By the way, when returning the plastic battery compartment cover, be very careful not to over tighten the screw, since this is just plastic and can be broken. For my Hyoki DT4261 digital multimeter, this one is also using rechargeable batteries. Here I installed 3 AA Inalop Pro rechargeable batteries. My Kyuritsu KEW2127R. This one runs on also 2 AAA size battery, and it's loaded with 2 Fujitsu rechargeable batteries size AAA inside. For my Fluke 116, Fluke 115 and 117, they use 9 volt batteries, and since I cannot find 9 volt rechargeable batteries at my local store, I use instead non-rechargeable lithium 9 volt batteries. I installed this Energizer Ultimate Lithium last March 2022. There are still no leaks here. Lithium batteries are also not known for leaking, so I am quite confident in leaving this battery here in my Fluke 116. My Sanwa YX360 TRF analog multimeter was damaged by a leaking alkaline battery before. As you can see in this battery post, its color is different. This one is darker with signs of oxidation compared to the other one, which is still new and shiny. This is my old oximeter, which was also damaged by a AAA alkaline battery leakage. It no longer works properly since that battery leak. The primary source of battery power then for my valuable test equipment are rechargeable batteries, either Fujitsu or Inalop, and lithium battery, the 9 volt lithium battery. I have very good experience with them. Not a single one of them has ever leaked after years of using them. Does it mean that I will only ever use these kinds of batteries in my test equipment and totally avoid disposable batteries? On the contrary, disposable batteries like carbon, zinc and alkaline are still useful as backup. They are easily accessible and they are cheaper than rechargeable batteries. And besides, because you do not need to charge them, there is no need to bring chargers on site. And they make a practical solution in case your battery charger encountered any kind of problem, or if any of your rechargeable batteries refuses to charge or just overheat in the battery charger. So it's always a good idea for me to have these disposable batteries as backup. I just make sure that they are fresh, they are not leaking, and I remove them after using in my test equipment before storage. I'd appreciate your comments and suggestions. Thank you for watching.